नमस्ते, माय नेम इज JVN ऋषि गौतम फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जर्नलिज्म। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सम बैरियर्स ऑफ ग्रेट कम्युनिकेशंस। मेनी पीपल थिंक अबाउट कम्युनिकेटिंग इज ईजी। इट इज आफ्टर ऑल something we have done all our lives. There is some truth in this simplistic view. Communicating is straightforward. What makes it complex, difficult, and frustrating are the barriers we put in the way. When communication doesn't happen, conflict often does. बैरियर्स ऑफ इफेक्टिव कम्युनिकेशन में जो पहला बैरियर है वह है फिजिकल बैरियर्स, दूसरा है परसेप्चुअल बैरियर्स, तीसरा है इमोशनल बैरियर्स, चौथा है कल्चरल बैरियर्स और पांचवा है लैंग्वेज बैरियर्स, छठा है जेंडर बैरियर्स, सातवां है इंटरपर्सनल बैरियर्स। तो नाउ we will start from first. The first one is physical barriers. Physical barriers in the workplace include marked out territories, empires, and five domes into which strangers are not allowed, closed office doors, barrier screens, and separate areas for people of different status, large working areas or working in one unit that is physical separate from others. As long as people still have a personal space that they can call their own, being close to others aids communication because it helps people get to know one another. Second is perceptual barriers. It can be hard to work out how to improve your communication skills. The problem with communicating with others is that we all see the world differently. If we didn't, we would have no need to communicate something like extra sensory perception would take its place. The following anecdote is a reminder of how our thoughts, assumptions, and perceptions shape our own realities. Means a traveler was walking down a road when he met a man from the next town. "Excuse me," he said, I am hoping to stay in the next town tonight. Can you tell me what the townspeople are like?" "Well," said the townsman, "how did you find the people in the last town you visited?" "Oh, they were an irascible bunch, kept to themselves, took me for a fool, overcharged me for what I got, gave me very poor service." "Well, then," said the townsman, "you will find them pretty much the same there." Next and third point is emotional barriers. One of the chief barriers to open and free communication is emotional. The emotional barriers is comprised mainly of fear, mistrust, and suspicion. The roots of our emotional mistrust of others lie in our childhood and infancy, When we were taught to be careful about what we said to others. Mind your P's and Q's. Don't speak until you are spoken to. Children should be seen and not heard. As a result, many people hold back from communicating their thoughts and feelings to others. They feel vulnerable. While some caution may be wise, excessive fear of what others might think stunts our development as effective communicators and our ability to form meaningful relationships. Fourth point is cultural barriers. When we join a group and wish to remain in it, sooner or later we will need to adopt the behavior patterns of the group. There are the behaviors that the group accepts as signs of belonging. The group rewards such behavior through acts of recognition, approval, and discussion. In groups there are happy to accept you, and when you are happy to conform, there is a mutuality of interest and a high level of win-win contact. Fifth point is language barriers. Our language may present barriers to others who are not familiar with our expression, buzzwords, and jargon. When we couch our communication in such language, it excludes others. Understanding this is key to developing good public speaking skills and report writing skills. In a global marketplace, the greatest compliment we can pay another person is to talk to them in their own language. One of the more chilling memories of the Cold War was the threat by the Soviet leader Nikita Khrushchev, who said to the Americans at the United Nations, "We will bury you." This was taken to mean a threat of nuclear annihilation. However, a more accurate reading of Khrushchev's words would have been, "We will overtake you." By this, he meant economic superiority. It was not just the language used that was the problem. Sixth is gender barriers. There are distinct differences between the speech patterns of men and women. A woman speaks between 22,000 and 25,000 words a day, whereas a man speaks between 7,000 and 10,000. In childhood, girls speak earlier than boys, and at the age of 3, have a vocabulary twice that of boys. The reason of this lie in the writing of a man's and woman's brain. Thank you.